That was my fault. Should have got someone to come up and play.
We need to investigate! Fire! So in IG97, Konami started a butt ton of music games with Beatmania. This game let you be a DJ by following a pattern on screen to play in time to. That might sound familiar. In 1998, Konami would probably put out their best known rhythm game with Dance Dance Revolution, where you use this to follow a pattern of arrows on screen to play in time to. Can you believe? This was the bloody tits. Every arcade worth going to had one of these. It was f***ing amazing. You couldn't have lines everywhere. Okay, but we ain't here to talk about that. Rock and roll games have existed before, but Konami totally set the standard. Enter Guitar Freaks and Drum Mania, wherein your controller is a bloody guitar or drums this time. Ain't that bloody amazing? They say if you had enough time with Drum Mania, you might walk away with some actual drumming ability. Then one day, Red Octane were looking at this piece of crap they were selling, and were like, let's make our own game. Looks a lot like Guitar Hero, don't it? Any horse. Red Octane then went to Harmonix, and together, they made Guitar Hero. This had full-on environments with stages to play on, crowds to play for, and songs we knew. When you have songs you know, it draws in a more casual crowd, you see. Wasn't all steak and onions, though. Sometime after Activision picked them up, they split in two. The team split in two. We have Rock Band to play now after Guitar Hero lost they damn minds. Rock Band was a new all-in-one plastic band with drums and singing, which Guitar Hero soon caught up to. Now Konami looked at all this and said, hey, that. Let's do that. Well, this can't be so bad. They started all this. They started all this. What can go wrong? No, it all went wrong. Okay, so that's one thing you're gonna run into a lot of. All of these covers. All but two of these songs are covers of common known stuff. Some ranging from okay. To bloody laughable. The instruments are alright, but jeebus those vocals. I can't understand why the original artist names aren't even listed in the songs. Like, I get you're supposed to be one band doing everything, that's why you got one guy and one girl singing everything. But where the crap is my ass made famous by? You could pay to download more, but most of it's a bunch of Pantera covers and Konami originals. Although, I really do like this version of My Only Shining Star. Make my only shining star, it can make your dreams come true. It can be my only shining star, it can do the same for you. And this seems to be the only place you can hear it. This ain't to say Guitar Hero isn't guilty of that. It ain't to say Rock Band isn't guilty of that. And don't get me started on GFDM. But you know what, those games were good. And what was it with every band game that year having f***ing R-Truth anyway? Like, who even did these? Well, it doesn't look much better either. Venues, characters, your heads-up display, it all looks bland. Bland, forgettable, and even a little nauseating compared to what we have otherwise. Like, we're not doing the thing where the symbols go straight down anymore. We have this angled thing now, Konami. Why not? Why? And it's not like Konami didn't have their own look, their own feel. They didn't want to go with that, though. They wanted to copy their copy. And this is what happens when you try to do that. But hey, freestyle guitar solos before Rock Band did it, very good. I didn't even tell you what I've been playing this thing on. I spawned it up this guitar because...
But at the end of the day, it's all about our killer drum peripheral.
Yeah, that's right, they didn't make one. Them drums, though. Six small drum heads smushed into a whole lot of plastic. Just don't miss.
Rock Revolution.
Now notice how I haven't said anything about microphones. That's because ain't no vocals. You can't sing here. I mean, they did put vocals on the DS version, because you know that will make me look like a crazy person when I'm out and about. All in all, I think all they should have done was just give us Guitar Freaks and Drum Mania, just like Beat Mania. We were already proven to like rocking games, and we played DDR when we didn't know what the songs were, much like DDR. Guitar Freaks and Drum Mania is just a unique experience that doesn't need to be compromised. I want to know about the property that made us play what we play today, not this. It's like that. This just comes off looking like some kind of poopy Guitar Hero ripoff because you tried to rip off the ripoff. What? And you know what? I'm gonna go play some real shit right now.